Hi everyone and welcome to this new Twinmotion tutorial. In today's video, we'll be looking at the new area tool. You can find that by clicking on populate, place, area. The first step you need to do when using the area tool is to create the area. So here my pen is selected, I'm going to move my camera up and I'm going to create a simple area. Once I close this area, you will see those arrows that start to appear on my terrain. That's all the spots that will be filled with an object that you will add to that drop box. So let's go to the vegetation folder, bushes, and let's, for example, drag and drop that common fern here. So as you can see here, all my arrow has been replaced by that common fern. If I'm now adding a tree, maybe that Northwest spruce here, it will have half common fern and half of that Northwest spruce. Let's click on that icon here to expand the property panel of the area tool. Right now here I can see all the options regarding that tool. So here we can play with the tension of the spline so we can have something super straight or fully smooth. We can also change the spacing. This defines the spacing between each entity. So with a very low value, the space will be really low and you will have higher density. But if you increase that, you will have a larger length between every object, a larger distance between every object, meaning less density overall. You can also increase the random spacing to create more of a cluster of objects. And you can also play with the probability. The edge falloff will make all the trees, all the objects on the side starting to decrease in height. So here, for example, you can see it on this side. Those trees are pretty close to the edge. If I'm increasing here the edge falloff, you will see that the height of the object will start to decrease when getting closer to the edge of the area. So right now here, I have that setup, but all that object, all those trees have roughly the same height. So I'm going to select to click on the object in my Dropbox. Here now I will display the settings of that specific object. So I have the scale, so if I'm raising that, I will raise the scale of all the trees at once. That's not what I want. What I want is just use the random scale to give randomness in terms of height to all those trees. I can also have a random rotation, again, just to give more randomness to the rotation. So now with this area tool, I can actually duplicate it if I want to fill the other area around my road. So let's grab some altitude here. I will select my area tool in my scene graph and I'm going simply to duplicate that. From there, I can turn it and of course, I can edit any points. So here, I can select this point, make it go this way, for example. If I want to add a point, I can click on the small plus that you can see between two points. So I have one point here, one point there. Exactly in the middle, I have that plus. If I click on it, this will create a new point and I can then edit my spline. And that's it for this video. Thank you everyone for watching it and we will see you all for the next one. Bye everyone.